Well, as we saw earlier, a protest at Ihumātao Māngere has highlighted the issue of Indigenous land rights. And here to give us her thoughts on the issues is organiser Sina Brown-Davis. Sina, thank you so much for joining us on the show today.
Salufalava, molurilei, ngā mihi kia kōrua.
Kapai. So, Sina, what is your stance on Ihumātao?
I'm 100% behind this kaupapa to support. Māori people, we only have 4-5% of our land left in our hands. And I think if our Pacific Island people who still hold most of their homelands, their lands at home and customary title, us Māori just having 4%. So this is not only about Ihumātao defending the whenua, this is like really important for us all.
Yeah. And why do you think our Pacific people have resonated with this protest so much?
It's Māngere. Ihumātao is at the back of Māngere. We've been joining whakapapa lines, intermarrying each other. I'm a product of that, of a few years now. We live together. There's a wide awakening of Indigenous rights around the world, and that's really resonated with our young people have been doing that through their social media, through their organising.
Yeah, do you agree that this has highlighted a wider issue of Indigenous rights for our Pacific peoples as well as Māori people?
Absolutely, land rights. I mean, our words for whenua are similar. Whenua, inua, vanua. It's all the same, and for all Indigenous peoples of the Pacific, our land is the bedrock of our genealogy, of our culture, of our food, of our ancestors, of everything. So we understand the importance of land to each other and can see that in that sacred whenua at Ihumātao.
Yeah, and we heard James Papali'i say in the story, you know, for Pacific people that have lived here in New Zealand, you know, for them, they feel almost like they're Māori because, you know, they've lived through the Māori struggle as well. Would you agree?
Yes and no. I mean, whakapapa's whakapapa. You're either Māori or you're not. We can understand how we feel, but I think he was alluding to the times when our Pacific communities came out in force to show their support for those struggles in the past. And we've had lots of individuals come, but I think it's now, aside from all the politics around it, that we celebrate our ancient genealogical connections and we respect and show honour to each other from the basis of our culture. So I think that's probably the next step, to show that our links have got nothing to do with the politics that are going on. Let the Pākehā politicians, let the politicians sort out the politics. Us as a community need to relate to each other from a deep level of respect, especially when it's about land.
On the other side of the fence though, kaumātua are for this development. What do you think?
That's none of my business. I'm not from there. I think that's their decision and their stuff that they have to work through. I'm there to support Pānia and the brilliant woman that conceptualised this campaign. I'm there to support the push to get that whenua back and to preserve our sacred spaces. And I think those internal issues are best looked after by those own people. As an outsider, I have no say in that.
Yeah, but today the Māori King is arriving at Ihumātao to meet with the organisers. The Kingitanga has said that they are also for the development. What do you think will come of those discussions this morning?
I think it's an honour for them just to be there. This shows the mana of Pānia and the Hokāinga and how they've held themselves, how they've made this a beautiful, peaceful event, how they've made it inclusive. So just having the King there is an honour, so I think the kōrero will be interesting, it will be feisty, but it's just like part of a process to make sure that soul and other whānau are all consulted, not the Crown. And I think my, I'm angry, not angry, but upset about that these Crown processes of treaty settlements have, that's what's pitting our people against each other, yeah? Mm-hmm. So to be mindful of that, that the Crown like to set up situations where whānau are pitted against whānau. So we're seeing like that treaty settlement stuff sort of fracturing and moving back to where it should be, land rights. It's all about land rights. It's all about land for Pacific people,
yeah.
Indigenous people.
What do you think should happen now?
That I would encourage, with much respect to our elders, all our cultural practitioners, please, my tonga nephew, start cooking those pigs so we can go and pay our proper respects as Pacific Islanders. This is South Auckland. And peaceful, the police presence was over the top. The police assumed brown people getting together, oh, there's going to be trouble. No, there's been peace. People are holding themselves in dignity. We actually all appreciate how special and very important and very rare it is for events to happen where all different types of people from all cultures are drawn to support.
Awesome. All right. Thank you so much, Sina, for joining us on the show today. We really appreciate your time, and I wish for the best resolution for everybody involved in this kaupapa.
Malo lava. Malo apito.
Ngā mihi kia koe. Thank you so much, Sina.